Oh, just close.
Yeah, he almost got that kill on RGB, but he did leave him smoked, so if they can pick off RGB, it might be a good chance to end this push. Or dream for that matter.
You know what? I think this might be it.
Well, Hybrid Edge did get the outside spawn. So, he can at least try to stop. Oh, they picked up the kill on green back in the day, so. And Hybrid Edge got the outside spawn. So, they might be able to stop this.
Well, this is the first flag attempt that we've seen so far, so. It's definitely a good start to the game. We're at 16 minutes and 10 seconds approximately in. Otacon is making his flag run right now. He is smoked, though, and in bad position.
Yeah, I don't see... Unless someone can pick up a clutch kill here, I just don't see how they're getting his flag out.
Oh, nice.
They got Spirit and Knight down. Only person they gotta beat is Hyper Dex, and they got this flag.
Well, you've got Dream coming up. Where's Kobe? Kobe's out.
Kobe's down bottom. He's trying to run around.
No, they replaced Kobe. Oh, sorry. No, they didn't.
White
My apologies.
Captured by green team.
Yeah, I don't see them. Yeah, this flag is definitely going in because this is starting.
Yeah, three. Oh, well, Kobe.
Nah, he's not. Yeah, he's
nah,
not
he had one shot. And Otacon's just smoothing it in.
White flag returned to green base.
So, first blood does go to the iLogic. Let's see what Ellen's reaction is going to be to this.
Well, iLogic is definitely happy about themselves right now. This win would secure them up a notch in the standings. Currently, the standings are, I believe it's iLogic at 3 points, LN at 4 points, which a win here would give iLogic a 7 point.
Our wins are worth three?
I'm quite sure, yeah. I think.
I thought wins were worth two. And ties were worth one. So isn't V 4-0 and they have 8 points?
I gotta double check. I've never actually, and you know, it's interesting, I'm head ref for SGL. I don't know the answer to this. Now, mainly I pay attention to who's sitting on the standings as opposed to the points themselves. So yeah, V is 4-0, you are correct. It's 2 points. One for a tie. Just a recap for the community here. I'm doing this on Fraps here as well, and I'm just taking a look at the league standings, so I'm not even in-game.
Well, we got LN making a push into... they still got three up. If they can get a kill or two here, they might be able to pull this flag out. Depending on what kind of spawn Green gets to.
I don't know if they're going to be able to pull this off. Knight can back up and try and hold it. Or Hybrid, I mean.
Nah, definitely not with that punch and Otacon. Hybrid is just going to go down now, 3v1.
And a nice bouncy from Lore. Smooth. Hybrid's not happy.
White flag returned to green base.
Knight was thinking of pulling back. Well, and he's just playing around here.
Yeah, well, if Otta had Hybrid might have been able to sneak back out of the base and wait for his team to come back up, but since Otta got that spawn, he got forced to go further back into the green space and just get raised. It was unlikely either way, but you know, there was that possibility.
Oh, Lord just took a couple of inappropriate hits.
Oh, Otto with a huge missile on Kobe right there.
I apologize to all the viewers after this broadcast. I did not catch that on the Fraps edition.
We have all four greens pushing in. You got Spirit, Smoke. All greens seem to be pretty good on health right now. This might be the second flag run right here.
Well, we had predictions if they didn't bring the starting lineup of this game going 2-0. Otacon with another nice missile.
White flag captured by green team.
Yeah, I think this is going to end it.
It's all going to depend on spawns right now.
Well, Kobe just...
But Hybrid got a very bad spawn here. You got PD phones going up top and try to make the gonna try to get in front. And you have Otto.
Well, he's got Otacon smoked, so DD's just letting himself. You know, I have to say it looked like DDP there was just kind of
he got caught into the smoke chase trap.
Yeah, he was
just kind of bait so your teammate can kill him. Probably would have been better for him to just keep going high and just try to make it further into green base and keep trying to get in front, but... But as we have it, second flag going in here for iLogic.
Green base. Green team wins.
So the score right now, folks, at 23 minutes in is 2-0. It looks as though it might be a 3-0 game. We have a timeout being called. So we've got 120 seconds on the timeout clock. So we've got Wave coming in for... for Spirit. Oh, it was for Hybrid. My apologies. So an interesting first half of the gameplay there. Let's see if a trade-off of Hybrid... Because honestly, Hybrid did not look like he was bringing his A-game. Whether it be that he's rusty, or whether it be that, you know, he just hasn't played in a while, or his head's not in the game today, he certainly wasn't looking all that good out there. Let's see if Wave can turn the tide.
It looks like Knight's just kind of off right now, too. He's usually their key player, but... I mean, right now he's sitting at like at 1-7. I mean, does anyone know who Kobe is? Cause I don't recognize him. He's the only person in here I don't recognize.
I'm not sure. I don't know actually. I'm being told by a member of the community that it's a bad guy. If that rings any bells to you guys.
Not really.
So the timeout is up.
It looks like Ellen was kind of caught a little bit there. They didn't know it was up, so they have them spawned at the beginning.
So you've got some information on Kobe from the community. Thanks again to all the community for your participation, by the way. So apparently Kobe was formerly a starter with Ella, Omega, and El Diablo in the semifinals versus CADF, is what I'm being told. What year was that? Was that a UAL match? Was that an SPL match? Last year or the year before? Just waiting on that information from the community. Taking a look here, Kobe has got Otacon smoked and on the run, but I think he's close to being hit to kill too.
And Otacon gets a nice spread after an eight and smooth.
Yeah, that was beautiful teamwork there.
Kill.
So apparently that was last year's SPL season of 2010. Well, I'll tell you what's really nice is you see TBWA, you see SYN, you see a lot of these teams who are not playing in this current SGL season. But it's nice that their players actually get an opportunity to join these other clans and play in this SGL matchup.
Yeah, some people actually look at it in the opposite way, though. Because they're like, oh, you're getting a really good player that would otherwise not be in your clan, you know?
Nah. I think that's just, you know, silly thinking. You know, everybody deserves an opportunity to play. And, you know, it's interesting. Atreyu made a very good point. Somebody had brought up the fact that iLogic has, you know... taken advantage of a mercenary state, so to speak. But Atreyu made mention of this, you know, it's team iLogic. It's not clan iLogic when it comes to an SGL matchup.
Yeah, like, I wasn't saying my personal opinion, I'm just saying what I've heard from a couple people in the community.
Yeah, no, we definitely understand that. So we've got a double flag run going on here. DDP is going to try and hold RZB back while Wave pushes with the flag. An aggressive move by Red. I don't know how it's going to pay off by LN. Smooth is up there. He's got Wave cornered.
Oh, but Oda gets a nice first combo into DDP clones right there.
Yeah, so that basically put them into a very dire situation.
White flag returned to green base.
Yeah, I think this is white it right here. It's in 3-0 for iLogic.
Unless Knight can pull this off, which, no, there's no way.
It's not happening because you're just going to have to, you're just going to have iLogic spawn the game with full health.
Yeah, exactly. All right, well, this has been an awesome game. We look forward to the post-game broadcast. If everybody wants to join us in the broadcast room, I will let you know right now in the broadcast room, you will not be able to speak. You'll be automatically suppressed until I unmute you. So questions from the community will be happening as well. First off, we would like to talk to the players of these games and see how they felt about their performance and what improvements they're looking at making in the future. Thanks again, everybody, for joining the live broadcast, and have a blast of a day from us here at SGL Broadcasting. By the way, the guest commentator today who's been working with me is Inuit.